अस्सलामु अलैकुम डियर स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ खिजरा आकिब। टुडे वी विल बी डूइंग पोइम नंबर 8, दैट इज़ द ग्रेट न्यूज़पेपर एडिटर टू हिज सबऑर्डिनेट। दिस पोइम इज़ रिटन बाय डीएच लॉरेंस। लॉरेंस इज़ अ फेमस नॉवलिस्ट एंड पोइट। ही इज़ मोर फेमस एज अ नॉवलिस्ट दैन एज अ पोइट। एंड दिस पोइम इज़ अ क्रिटिक ऑन द इंग्लिश रीडरशिप, ऑन द न्यूज़पेपर रीडर्स ऑफ इंग्लैंड। ही हैज़ क्रिटिसाइज्ड दैट दे आर द शैलो सुपरफिशियल पीपल। दे डू नॉट वांट टू गो इन टू द डेप्थ ऑफ द थिंग्स। दे ओनली लाइक सच आर्टिकल्स, सच न्यूज़ एंड such texts in which they are you may say in which they are praised, admired. The writings which present to them a beautiful picture of the people of England. They do not like to know anything depressing, anything that highlights their weaknesses. And the editors of the newspaper understood this very fact, and they tried to cater to the interests and taste of the people instead of showing them the true picture of the of their lives and of their way of thinking. So in this poem, an article writer has tried to highlight the actual situation, but the editor scolds him and he reprimands him because of showing the true picture of the things. He says that he must show the brighter side of the picture. He must show the happy things. He must write the happy things, the things that would give pleasure and amusement to the readers, because they do not want to get depressed and tense. Okay, let's start reading the poem. Mr. Smith, Mr. Smith, haven't I told you to take the pith and marrow and substance out of all the articles passing beneath your scroll? And now look here what you have gone and done. You have told them that life isn't really much fun, when you know that they have got to think that they are happy. As happy as happy, oh so happy you sappy. Think of the effect on Miss Harrison when she reads that her life isn't really much fun. She'll take off her specs and she'll put down the paper as if it was giving off poison vapor, and she'll avoid it. She'll go and order the Morning Smile, sure that it will afford her comfort and cheer, sure that it will tell her she is a marvelous, delicious, high-spirited feller. You must chop up each article, make it peppy and easy to swallow. Always tell them they are happy. Suggest that they are spicy, yet how pure they are, and what a sense of true humor they have got. Ha ha. Mr. Smith, Mr. Smith, have you still to learn that pith and marrow and substance are sure to be indigestible to Miss Ponsonby? The editor of the newspaper is scolding Mr. Smith, one of his employees. Mr. Smith couldn't understand that he should not present the dark and gloomy picture of life to the people of England, because they want to stay happy and overjoyed always. For them, life is just like a merry-go-round. They do not want to think beneath the surface. They do not want to face the bitter realities of life. And the editor understands that if he shows the darker aspect of life to the people, his newspaper will not be as famous as it is at this time. That's why he is scolding Mr. Smith. Mr. Smith, Mr. Smith, haven't I told you to take the pith and marrow and substance out of all the articles passing beneath your scroll? Pith means the gist or the main theme. Marrow is in fact the soft substance inside the white bones. But here pith and marrow or the substance means the gist and main idea or main theme. The articles passing beneath your scroll. Scroll means illegible handwriting, bad handwriting, unclear or the writing that is written in a careless way. So the editor is asking from Mr. Smith to take out the pith and marrow, to take out the gist, the main thing from the articles and just write or publish the superficial idea, the skeleton of the article, but the inside in-depth theme should not be provided to the people. And now look here, what you have gone and done. You have told them that life isn't really much fun and you have done a really horrible thing for the people of England, because you have told them that life is not as happy, as pleasurable, as amusing as they are thinking. You have committed a blunder that would have a very negative impact on the people and they would leave reading this newspaper. When you know that they have got to think that they are happy, as happy, as happy, how so happy, you sappy. You have done this in spite of the fact that you know that the people of England want to stay happy. As happy as happy. Here, as happy means as happy as a foolish man. They want to be happy to the extent of foolishness. Oh, so happy, you sappy. Sappy means sentimental. You, the emotional fool, the sentimental. Why have you tried to show them the darker aspect of life or the painful picture of the life? When you know that the people of England do not want to be sad, they want to stay happy ever. Think of the effect on Miss Harrison when she reads that her life is not really much fun. Have you imagined what impact would this article have on Miss Harrison, who thinks that her life is full of merrymaking and amusement, when she would come to know that her life is not as happy as she thinks? What impact would there be on her? She'll take off her specs and she will put down the paper. In the very next line, he explains the impact that would be. He explains the effect of such an article on the readers. He has given the example of Miss Harrison, that she would take off her spectacles. She will take off her specs, her glasses, her spectacles, and she will put down the paper. She will throw off this newspaper as if it was giving off poison vapor. She would discard this newspaper as if it were emitting some poisonous steam, some poisonous spray. She would create a distance from this newspaper, as it is something poisonous, as it is something horrible, as it is something dangerous, and she will avoid it. She will not look into it. She will not like to read this newspaper. She'll go and order the Morning Smile, and rather she will prefer to read the Morning Smile that would make her happy, that would show her the brighter aspect of the life, that would discuss the light things in the morning. Early in the morning, people do not want to get depressed. Sure that it will afford her comfort and cheer. Sure, it is really sure, there is no doubt that this newspaper will bring her comfort and cheer. Comfort, peace, solace and happiness. Cheer means happiness. Sure that it will tell her she is a marvelous, delicious, high-spirited feller. Marvelous, awesome. Delicious, really very amusing. Delicious usually means something that is tasty. It is used for food, but the term delicious for Miss Harrison means that she is really an interesting and amusing character. High-spirited feller, enthusiastic, lively, and happy fellow. Feller means fellow. She would like to read the Morning Smile, which would offer her comfort and peace, happiness, pleasure, and also tell her that she is an awesome, interesting and full of life fellow. You must chop up each article, make it happy and easy to swallow. Always tell them they are happy. Your job is to cut short the articles. Chop up, cut short. Make it peppy, peppy, soft, something soft, something the people would like to read. And easy to swallow, digestible, easy to swallow, that is digestible, that is easy to be taken in. Always tell them they are happy. Your job is to make the articles flavorful for the people. Suggest that they are spicy, yet how pure they are. You have to tell them that they love spicy articles, that they love the things that would make them happy, but they are pure people. You don't have to tell them their vices. You don't have to tell them what is the actual situation in life, but your job is to tell them that they are the pure and innocent people, and what a sense of true humor they have got. You also have to admire them. You also have to admire their sense of humor. Haha. This haha means that Mr. Smith himself knows that the people of England are not as good, and they do not have as a sharp sense of humor as he is dictating his employee to highlight, to show, to write in his articles. But he is doing this for his readership, for making his newspaper popular among the people, for making his newspaper acceptable by the people. Mr. Smith, have you still to learn that pith and marrow and substance are sure to be indigestible to Miss Ponsonby? Mr. Smith, have you still have to learn, haven't you understand up till now that the pith and marrow, that the real substance, the real gist or the main theme of the articles is not digestible to the people like Miss Ponsonby, because the real presentation of the things make them unhappy, make them depressed. Okay, girls, this was all about the poem. And the main theme of the poem is the criticism, is satire on the readers of the on the readers of England. Okay, girls, satire is in fact a literary device which the authors, the poets, dramatists, novelists or essay writers use to highlight the vices of the people, and their aim is not to only criticize the people, but their aim is the improvement in the behavior of the people. Their aim is to teach the people, is to correct the vices, the wrongdoings in the society. The aim of satire is always the improvement of the situation. This is not only criticism for the sake of criticism, rather it is criticism for the sake of improvement in the behavior of the life of the people. This was all about this poem. You have to prepare the critical appreciation, MCQs and short questions of this poem. Okay, girls, I hope you would have enjoyed this lesson, this poem. Thank you. Allah Hafiz.